YouTube, Optimus Smythe back for another video review, something that I got not quite such a long time ago, but recently, sometime this spring semester. I just bought him at Walmart, because he looked pretty sweet. This is Generations Thrust. We finally have an American Thrust figure, and he's very good. He comes from the classic, like, Seeker type line that Starscream started with. Classics, Universe 2.0, whatever. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. He's nicely... The good thing about this one is he's got a new mold. Like, he's got a new head. Weapons are the same as Starscream, but he has these different fins on the back, different wings. You know, that's pretty sweet. Oh, I forgot to show you how to use the landing gear. It's not out. These things are supposed to be out, although it does still stay on the ground pretty good, even without the landing gear. I forgot that this mold had landing gear until I actually got this figure. I didn't even know that my Universe Starscream figure had it until I actually learned about this figure having it. So, yeah, there he is. Now, I'm going to compare him next to Starscream here for just a second, real quick. Give me a second. Now, you can see the main differences, obviously, like I said, the wings, the fins. The guns are still the same, although he's got a longer nose. And yeah, I just want to show you guys that my Starscream, I panel lined him with a what are these things? Give me one second. Just showing this off. Thought I'd show it off. This is a Faber-Castell Pitt Artist pen with India ink, and this is a bee or brush. You could also use other ones, I guess, but it would probably be better to use an S for small or something else smaller than that. But yeah, I drew on them and then kind of rubbed it off with my finger or a tissue or something. You probably should use Q-tips instead. I'd recommend that. And then it left itself inside the lines, and it kind of stained in some spots, like right here. But it looks a lot better now, even in robot mode. I did some of the bottom down here. Just thought I'd show you guys that. But now back to Thrust. These things, they will shoot, obviously. The triggers are on the bottom side. They'll shoot out pretty hard, so be careful to not lose them. Same as they've ever been, though, pretty much. And if you want, you can rearrange these things in different orders. You can put these on top or even under here. Or you could put these things under there if you want, or under here, or whatever. Or you can just not use them at all, and you can do this, which looks kind of dumb to me, but yeah. Now, let's transform him. I'm not going to show you guys, like, word for word how to transform him, because it's the exact same as Starscream, except you don't flip up those other extra fins that are on the side. These don't flip up. They stay like this, but they do go down like that. Yeah, not going to show you guys. You can watch. I am showing you. I'm just not saying how to do it, but you guys pretty much know the drill. Only difference in transformation is up here. Instead, just turn the head, and you don't have to take the cone off and flip it around or anything like that. Just because the nose cone of the jet is his head, pretty much. He's a cone head seeker. That's how it is with them. Looks funny, but yeah. There he is with all his cone-headed glory. Now just bring the fists out right here. And it's a very nice figure. So there he is. There's Thrust. Pretty G1 accurate. Even the vehicle mode is. Now for these things, let's put them on. I like to put them on so that this thingy is facing outside out, so it doesn't hit up against his wing and like keep him from movements, you know. So put that one on there, and then take these things. I like to put them on the back right here. I just keep them on the back so that way they're not in the way of his null rays. Other way around. And the Decepticon logos are on those things, but like right now you can't see them, unfortunately. But at least they're not upside down like with Starscream. That's even stupider. Yeah. So yeah, there they are on the back, and there's the Decepticon logos. Yeah, he's pretty sweet. Articulation's same exact thing as Starscream's, only the head is actually, it can't turn quite as much as Starscream's can, even though we don't have that annoying thing hanging out on the back. But he's nice, though. Is he worth getting? Sure. I mean, if you like the Seeker mold, if you want to collect them, go ahead. They've got Generations Thundercracker out right now, which I recommend you get. And then, and then there's Dirge. I haven't gotten myself to buying Dirge yet because there's so much other figures I'd rather have. So, He keeps falling over. I'm sorry. He's not very good at standing. None of the Seekers ever really were. I can't get myself to buy Dirge because so much other better figures are out right now, so I can't see it happening anytime soon. It might not even happen, but Dirge is another Conehead Seeker. Maybe I will get him just to increase my classic Decepticon count, but this is pretty good, though. I recommend him. He's cheap, he's inexpensive, so it's good. So yeah, that is Generations Thrust. Thank you guys for watching my review, and this is Optimus Smythe signing off.